from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shone. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken, as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The words of God for God's people. It's not possible, of course, in the season to fit in every carol. There are so many wonderful carols of Christmas to be shared. But we'll be sharing three or four of them here. So I invite you to turn to the insert in your bulletin. And we'll be singing a couple of verses from each of the three carols that are here, beginning with Angels Who Have Heard on High. You might want to stand up for this part, those who are able to do so.
Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er.
Still we see thee high, above thy dear.
upon the midnight clear. Thanksgiving for his life, and to give two or three maybe an opportunity to share some of the gift of what he meant to you. He was a chaplain, I believe, at the hospital in Portland for quite some time, and many people took clinical pastoral education under his guidance. And so if there are any who would like to share, we invite you to do that at this time. The wicked album for that one. Thank you.
Yeah, well, I knew Dick Sheesley when I was a little kid because his daughter and I were about the same age and we did youth group and camp and all of that. He was actually in Lewiston at Central Maine Medical Center, pastoral director.
Oh, here in Lewiston.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah. And then he was here for the interim period between two pastors for us. But Dick was this really kind, emotional, caring person who, I assume he said this in a sermon here, which probably may not, but he and Ruth had three children, and their middle child, Melinda, actually contracted leukemia at a very young age. Mm-hmm. So a lot of their young parenthood was spent dealing with her illness, but they faced it with the most amazing courage, and it was for those of us that were contemporary kids in that time, Melinda died quite young, to see the parents, the example that they were, was pretty amazing. And it was a thrill for me when Dick came for that short time to be here, because he had been such a great mentor and friend for so long.
Thank you. Appreciate you sharing that.
When he was here, one of the big things he brought to the church was a big visioning process. I remember you talked about that. And I believe the vision statement we read tonight, he was instrumental in helping craft that.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Any others want to share? Well, let us be in prayer. Oh, go ahead.
I was just going to say, I knew Dick and would remember him for meeting a group at the Hospital of Nurses that supported us, and it really helped us to do our work at the hospital and be much more effective for our patients. And he had a very kind and gentle way of being, and he always looked for ways to be of service to other people.
Thank you. Let's be in prayer together. God, we thank you for all those who are gifts in our life's journey. And we do thank you for your servant, Dick Kiesling, for his pastor here at a difficult time in our church's journey. We do remember him with love and thank you for the gift of his spirit, and ask that you would be with each of his family during this time and season of loss. One of the traditions that we've been sharing the last couple of years here at the United Methodist Church of Auburn is remembering some of those who are a part of our life's journey, who may not be with us physically because they've entered into God's presence, and to remember them at this time of year by placing a bell of Christmas remembrance upon the tree that is over here to my left. There may be others who are precious to us who cannot be here for one reason or another. Perhaps they're deployed overseas or whatever the reason might be. And so we also have bells that have yellow ribbons, and those are available for us to remember them and to place those on the tree as well. So as you might feel led, we invite any of you who wish to come and to take a bell or two and place it upon the tree as we remember them together. Thank you.